take for granted that we enter a discussion about two different subjects, since the two of them had invested in completely different goals. Bruce Lee had invested in becoming the best fighter, while Jackie Chan had invested in incredible knowledge, indifferent to whether or not he would lose to Superman. Therefore, this is a philosophical debate, and it depends on what we are looking at. Are we examining who was faster in punching? Who could jump higher? Who was better in bed? No, it is more than clear that we are talking about who was a greater martial artist. And when we talk about a martial artist, the first thing we have to take into account is knowledge. And the knowledge that Jackie Chan had acquired was so great that, to be fair, Bruce Lee couldn't have imagined even in his dreams. In order to make a movie, Jackie Chan used to master the system. Tiger, crane, snake, leopard, wing chun, things that are not based on rumors, but things that we see with our own eyes. A typical example is the movie Drunken Master, in which he performs the 8 forms of the drunken gods in single shots and in such a precision that it means that he knew them. And this is just an example of only one movie. Anyone who has been training in forms deeply, and not just to dance the forms, understands how huge a feat this is. On the other hand, Bruce Lee had passed 2-3 systems and not in detail. All he knew was Wing Chun and not completely. As a result, to fill his gaps, he pulled out a system of his own, borrowing techniques from other systems, mainly Wing Chun, which he didn't know completely, but he knew it very well. One could say, yes, okay, about technique, but what about fighting ability? And who said that Jackie Chan was not a good fighter? We've seen both of them fighting only in the movies. The difference is that Jackie Chan's fighting ability has not mythicized, and after all, he has never invested in this, while we have testimonies from his teammates that it was impossible to beat him. On the other hand, about Bruce Lee, we have even created myths. Many even claim that no man in the world would be able to beat him, which is one of the most utopian things I've ever heard. Even assuming that Bruce Lee would win against Jackie Chan in a battle, which personally I consider it very likely, why not? It wouldn't make him a greater martial artist. Mike Tyson or Carelli would definitely beat Bruce Lee. But that doesn't make them greater martial artists than Bruce Lee. As long as both Bruce Lee and Jackie Chan had great fighting skills, it doesn't matter who would win. Many argue that Bruce Lee was a greater martial artist because he had reached his body limits with much more training. Completely wrong, because Jackie Chan had incredible physical ability, not to say greater than Bruce Lee. about training? Only to be able to execute forms in such a way that only masters of the system can perform like he did, we are talking about hundreds of hours of hard training. As we said, Bruce Lee was a tremendous martial figure, much bigger than anybody he would even lose to. That's because he made his mark even through films, something that many accuse him of. But the truth is that everyone knows Bruce Lee, and almost no one knows Karelin. But even in this sector, Jackie Chan has left a greater mark. Jackie Chan produced much more material, much more difficult films, with much bigger variety in combat scenes, with always different styles and much more quality. Bruce Lee's fighting scenes are considered a little bit sloppy. In this one, he has grabbed dummies. Jackie Chan's battle scenes consisted of 100 moves in one single shot. Which means huge work. Bruce Lee threw two punches and one kick, and then they were changing scene. His scenes were very easy. Plus, Jackie Chan had the ability to participate in every scene, while Bruce Lee could not execute every movement, so he was using dubbing. Many others, in order to support Bruce Lee's unparalleled ability, advertise his handling of nunchakus. There are even mythical videos about this, which of course are not real. However, yes, he had excellent skill, but only in nunchakus. On the other hand, Jackie Chan could handle many different weapons with incredible skill. And not only nunchakus, which is considered one of the easiest weapons, and almost anyone can learn it with minimum training. In addition, even in kinesiology, Jackie Chan could easily put on a wig and make Bruce Lee's moves and imitate him. But the other way around, no way. I am sure that a lot of people will hate me after this video, but unfortunately the mindset that I have developed through Wing Chun is not to make discounts on the truth. Nowhere do I say that Bruce Lee was not a huge martial artist, a shiny personality, and personally I admire him very much. He is an exemplar for me. Besides, he had learned Wing Chun under the same lineage as I do, Wong Sung Loin, so I have many reasons to support him, but I have no reason to be unfair. I think there is a lot of food for thought, so at this point I will salute you and I will see you guys in the next video.